We've seen more than 2 months of anti-government protests, sometimes violent. When is the government going to get the message and resign?
We are getting a lot of different messages from the protests, but we are also getting messages from those that are not on the protests. Some of the messages, those messages that are for better judicial system, for more justice, and for fight against corruption, these are messages that we hear and we do want to pursue in our politics.
Милиона на Горанов. Кога ще ги разследват? Кога, господине? 700 милиона са.
Чуваме ли се от тук? Чуваме ли се от 8-те джуджета? Чуваме ли се относно необходимостта да се провери дейността на Пепи Еврото? Твърденията, че има твърде близки контакти с елитни прокурори от специализираната прокуратура.
Не споделям виждането на десните екстремисти.
Well, the message from the opinion polls is pretty clear. 70% distrust the government and the personal confidence rating of the prime minister has dropped to just 20%, the lowest rate in years. So the crowds are telling you they don't want you. They don't want your new draft constitution. They want immediate elections. So why not give them to the crowd?
Because there are not more than 6,000 people on the street and there are more than 1 million people who have voted for this government.
People don't want to wait for that. They've seen enough corruption. They've seen enough brutality on the streets now. The violence has been condemned as widely excessive, violence by the police.
I wouldn't agree with your strong words about violence. I can tell you that there are more than 80 policemen that are actually now in hospital and that have been, against them has been a lot of violence on behalf of the public.
What kind of system is this where the Prime Minister is pictured asleep in his official residence, a gun beside his bed, and a drawer in his bedside table stuffed full of 500 euro notes? What kind of government is this?
What are your proofs that these photographs are actually true? And is this what is superiority of law? Just broadcasting pictures with where the prime minister is not on one and the same picture with this 500 notes of euro. If we're talking about democracy and if we're talking about superiority of law, it's the court that must actually say whether this is true or not.
Всичко това е нагласено. И то преди една година е гласено. Но оставаше само да има едно малко момче до мене и дет се вика, от тук се фърла направо.
На жаргон ще го казвам, ме сготвиха по един много, много елементарен начин. С една прекрасна госпожа, която дойде и наштрака в мое отсъствие всичките тези работи.
Both Bulgaria and the government you serve in have become bywords for corruption internationally. Corruption, mafia capture, democratic backsliding and a politically manipulated and almost dysfunctional justice system. I wonder why you continue to serve in a government which is so mired in scandal.
Because this is the government which doubled the teacher's salary in the country. This is the government which invested 2.5 billion euro in the education system.
Около 80 000 напълно неграмотни млади българи, 41% или всеки втори тинейджер функционално неграмотен, над 30% от българските граждани приключват образованието си преди 15-16 годишна възраст, функционално неграмотните в България изобщо над 56%.
This is the government which doubled the GDP in the last years and also is the government that constantly increases the incomes of the people. As I told you, life is no longer black and white.
Your figures are extraordinary. Your GDP growth over the last 10 years has been around 50%. In contrast to Romania, which joined on the same day as you, the European Union, and has registered an increase of more than 200%. You have the lowest average salary in the EU, with less than 690 euros a month, less than Bosnia and Montenegro, which aren't even in the EU. And the European Council on Foreign Relations says it's a sign you've made very poor use of EU cohesion funds. Why is that? Mismanagement and corruption, or is it both?
This is not true because the minimum salary in the country when we started in the country was 250 leva. Now it's 610 leva.
Last year, the U.S. State Department said that while your laws provided penalties for corrupt officials, the government did not implement that law effectively. Officials in all branches of government reportedly engaged in corrupt practices with impunity. So the inescapable conclusion is that you allow this corruption because members of your government and criminals connected to it are profiting by it day by day. That's why the State Department underlined multiple reports of government corruption. And they included bribery, conflict of interest, elaborate embezzlement schemes, procurement violations, and influence trading. This is full service corruption right across the spectrum of your government. Did you think the world wouldn't notice what was going on?
I can tell you that in the last years, the Commission for Fighting Against Corruption and Confiscating of Illegal Acquired Property has done preliminary precautions for over half a billion leva and has been done more than 9,000 different checks and revisions of different officials on different levels, including local and national governments.
Повече с тези компроматни глупости аз няма да се занимавам. И чакайте, обяснявам защо.
Колко души ползват въпросната тераса, защото вие това
повече
казвате?
Повече с глупости аз няма да се обяснявам.
Никой от съседите му не се е качвал на терасата покрив. Самите навеси, почти 60 квадрата, пък се оказаха незаконни.
Изцяло трябва да бъдат премахнати?
Да, изцяло трябва да бъдат премахнати тези два навеса.
Изненадващо шефът на строителният надзор реши, че експертите в Слатина не са прави.
Възможно ли е да няма строителни книжа един покрив и да бъде законен?
Възможно е, когато това е допустимо.
Пламен Георгиев подаде оставка, тя беше гласувана от парламента и почти светкавично правителството реши, че той е най-подходящ за поста генерален консул в Валенсия. Владеенето на испански език беше посочено като предимство. Дипломата, показваща знанията на Георгиев, обаче се оказа пълна с грешки. Премиерът защити назначението.
Просто кажете с какво той ви печели, за да го изпратите да представлява вас и мен. Нали така? Той това ще прави.
Убеждам вас.
Не, хората убедете.
Вие сте убедени по друг начин. Взехме решение, изпратихме консул в Валенсия. Хиляди такива консули.
Last year, the Center for the Study of Democracy in your own capital, in Sofia, said that at least 35% of public procurement contracts involve corrupt practices. This is the kind of country that you've turned Bulgaria into, and you still think you should stay on in government. Transparency International rates your country as the most corrupt in the European Union and has done for the last 7 years consecutively.
Why don't we quote the Eurobarometer in this respect and the statistic which they have announced that, for example, 58% of the respondents in Bulgaria say that in their everyday life they didn't meet corruption.
Well, I don't know which Eurobarometer you're looking at, but the one last year said that 80%, according to it, 80% think that there is widespread corruption. 78% think that the only way to succeed in business is to have political connections. These are statistics that would shame any developing nation around the world, let alone a member of the European Union. Minister, why is there so little respect in your government for the free press, which is, after all, the bedrock of any democratic state?
More than 60% of the media coverage in Bulgaria is critical against the government. I wouldn't say that this is lack of freedom of press.
Freedom House reported that when a pro-government journalist and politician, Emil Koshlugov, was appointed last year to head Bulgarian national TV, all the critical voices were silenced. Same with the Nova Broadcasting Group. New owners came in, investigative journalists were fired.
I wouldn't agree with this as well, because in one of the most popular shows on the Bulgarian national television. This Friday, for example, was one of the main leaders of the opposition and one of the main leaders of the protests.
Аз не съм имал възможност да гостувам при вас от близо 4 години.
Earlier this year, Reporters Without Borders accused your government of trying to intimidate journalists. It said they've been subjected to a series of verbal attacks and threats by very senior officials since the beginning of February. They talked about the Prosecutor General, the Speaker of the National Assembly.
Не знам, Вашингтон знам, че е обучено. Ще разследвате ли господин Пеевски?
Ще разследваме всеки, за който има доказателства за извършено престъпление. И не се притесняваме и също го доказвам.
А за Москва как е време?
Вие с конкурси сте назначени.
Тя не, ама чакай,
аз не съм
на длъжност, от която се изисква.
Сложили са ви на време, на договора са ви удължили.
И вашия конкурс...
И останахте сам на всичкото отгоре.
Това какво общо има?
Вие нямате ли роднини? Те не работят ли някъде?
Работят.
Къде работят? Използвали са връзките на водещия на нова телевизия?
Най-вече.
Точно това е станало. Бъдете сигурни. Утре, ако съм злонамерен, ще разработя един на Виктор Гейт.
During a press conference in Sofia on February the 4th, your prime minister likened reporters, especially female reporters, to turkeys. And then he grotesquely tried to mock them by making sounds imitating the way turkeys gobble. Is that how you respect the free press in your country?
Ето вие като някакви мисирки тичате.
Our prime minister has his own specifics in his language and he didn't meant to be rude to any of the journalists. And in this respect, I don't think that this is a serious accusation about lack of freedom of press.
Просто цвета да кажа, аз съм просто кърджалистка.
Се ядосам на тега чули много неща от мен. После я прегърна, чуда я. И прощаваш, ако знае, че го прав с душа.
Every journalist is freely supposed to talk about the government and the use of social media in the country is really enormous. And internet media is very, very critical about the government.
Why this constant intimidation? Is your government afraid of the truth?
Do you see me being afraid of the truth?